Hello darlings, in this pick a card video there is a back to school message to help you have a wonderful and successful semester. I call on forces higher than I to unleash the wisdom I hold inside. Let this message be compassionate and true to show someone what they must do. Tap into the infinite wisdom of your own inner guide. Ask it to reveal to you what is hidden deep inside. Take what you need and ignore what doesn't apply by selecting the color of the right butterfly. Listen to the whispers of your own inner voice and let it help you make the true butterfly choice with the lessons and insights that will help you grow and lead you in the direction that you choose to go. Let's see what the Jungle Beauty Goddesses have to say to help someone find their way. Hello, darling. If you selected the blue butterfly, this reading is for you. So we're going to go over some tips to help you be successful when you go back to school this semester. I'm going to go over the cards with you, and I'm going to give you my collective intuition about your hand. So the first card I have for you is from Jungle Beauty Goddess Katara, who represents Earth, our foundation, structure. She says, true beauty is an act well done. I can just tell you right off the bat, this card is saying that whatever you do this semester, please make sure that you do your best. When you turn in your assignments, go that extra mile. Don't just do enough just to get by. And I know sometimes students just feel like, well, at least I completed it. Think like this. So imagine that everybody else maybe got the right answer. But what if you just took it one step further and you put it on good paper, or you drew a really nice picture, or you added some additional information? So this card is telling you to go out of your way this semester, and if you do that, you are going to do extremely well, because beauty is an act well done. This means that a lot of times students are focused on what jeans they're going to wear, what clothes they're going to wear, how am I going to look, oh, who's looking at me? But true beauty is when you do your absolute best. The next card I have for you, oh my God, we're pulling in strong Jungle Beauty Goddess Katara, who represents our Earth Foundation. Let's see what her message on this card reads. So her message to you is, your relationship with money is rooted in your childhood. Now, I think in this particular reading, money and school correlates, because people go to school because they want to establish a career. If you come from a family that has said, maybe you're not good enough, or you're not smart, or you're just like your granddaddy, he wasn't good in school either, or your family doesn't put a lot of emphasis on doing well, they just feel like you just need to get by, whatever core beliefs you have about school, they are going to affect your ability to do extremely well in school. To do well, not just this semester, child, but period. So what I really want you to think about is, what is your family's culture about school? Did your mom graduate? Did she do well in school? What about your dad? What about your siblings? What about your family in general? Look at your family in general and see, and look for some type of patterns. Are you the first person in your family to really do well in school? Are there people, like friends, who kind of look down on people who are really smart and call them nerds? Whatever, I just want to say that there are some cultural, generational, foundational beliefs that you may have that you're not aware of that's affecting your ability to do well. And once you remove those core beliefs, you're going to have an awesome semester. But make sure you're not playing on a pattern based on the people who are a part of your life or your community. The next, oh my God, we're pulling in Katara again for you, darling. Again, she represents Earth, and she also represents the cave child. The cave means it is time for you to get in that cave. Turn away from social media. Leave your friends alone. I mean, turn off your cell phone. It is time for you to get serious. This is serious, okay? It's time for you to put the booty to the mix. It's time for you to get down to business, get down to earth. How about that? And really cross your T's and dot your I's in terms of being very practical and getting ready for school. If you're going to do well this semester when you go back to school, you have a hand that's telling you that you really need to get grounded. And one of the things you can do to get grounded is walk barefoot in the park or on grass. If you could just go outside for like 5 minutes, even if you live in the city, if you can find a patch of grass, and because while the weather is still good, even if it's not that good, and just stand with your legs slightly parted and with your bare feet on the grass, imagine like some the root chakras. Like I always imagine like some red roots coming from the bottom of my feet into the connecting to the center of the earth. And I imagine that the earth sends me like this tremendous grounding energy that comes up to the top of my head, all the way up to the central sun, which connects with the central sun. And the central sun brings this energy back down through my crown chakra in my head, all the way through my body, all the way back down through my feet and through the earth. So you have a light coming in from the center of the earth and a light coming from the central sun that is this beautiful pink. Because I always imagine the light from the earth is like being this beautiful red, and the light from the central sun being this beautiful white. And you have this vibrant pink energy that's spreading out through your body, and it's keeping you grounded so that you can do well. Now the card that I have for you, sorry I talk so much, it says ask your body what it needs to feel wealthy. Now again, you're really, like I said, you're pulling in some strong Katara energy. So wealth in this sense, because people go to school for their careers, right? Your grades are your wealth. Your grades will determine what schools you go to, who employs you, what opportunities become available to you. You need to, like, child, cut the junk out. I know a lot of colleges and high schools, they have a lot of vending machines with a lot of garbage. Don't do it. Like, eat healthy. Your hand is telling you that if you're going to do well this semester, you need to get enough sleep, you need to go to bed, you need to develop a schedule, you need to become extremely organized. The first thing I'm going to tell you to do is try to develop some type of schedule. I call it a study schedule, and make it a very sacred time for you, which means that you will, let's say it's Saturdays from 10 to 4. That is the time you study. You don't let anybody interfere with that time. It's a sacred time for you. If you get a job or whatever, you have to tell them that you have other commitment at that time. You're not going to do well in school unless you are very grounded, rooted, committed, okay, and very practical, because you're pulling in some very strong Katara Earth energy, which is telling you to go into your cave, take care of your body, eat healthy, develop a time management system, read ahead of time, do your homework ahead of time, do your absolute best, and you're going to have an awesome semester. I have one more card for you, and it is from Jungle Beauty Goddess Namib, who represents our crown chakra. And her message to you is, give your mind time to accept the wisdom of your soul. Forgive yourself. Now, what I think this card means is that I think maybe in the past, you haven't been the best student. But you know what? You were the best person you knew how to be at that time. And we're all here to evolve, to grow. Let go. This card is telling you, look, everybody make mistakes. Let the past be the past. Okay, when you jump into your semester, this school year, darling, when you jump in, whatever, you know, I want you to know that whatever grades that you may have gotten in the past, they do not represent who you are today, that you are going to have a very awesome semester. You're going to be organized. You're going to take care of yourself, right? You're going to have excellent time management skills. You're going to cut back on social media. And as a matter of fact, if I were you, in the very beginning of the semester, just leave social media alone altogether. Just, you know, some time. Make sure you know, the first thing I want you to do is develop your study schedule. I want you to stay grounded. Another thing you can do to stay grounded, in addition to walking in the park, is I'd like for you to buy some cinnamon essential oil, and just a little bit, just a dab a dab dab, and dab it at the very bottom of your foot, like right in the center, because cinnamon oil, it grounds you, it centers you, and it helps remove like old childhood traumas, old beliefs, things that are holding you back. I really hope you have a wonderful back to school semester. I know you would do well if you can take in consideration some of the ideas that the Jungle Beauty Goddesses have provided for you. Thank you so much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you, darling, in the next video. Hello, darling. If you selected the pink butterfly, this reading is for you. First, I'm going to go over the cards, and then I'm going to give you my collective intuition about this hand. The first card I have for you is from Jungle Beauty Goddess Katara. She's with a lot of energy tonight. And she represents Earth and our ability to be centered, to be practical. She says, don't ignore physical pain. Her message to you this semester so far is to please take it. More likely is to get enough sleep, child. Cut back on the junk. Make sure that you are eating healthfully. Sometimes we cut back on junk, but you know, get a lot of green leafy vegetables in your diet, a lot of, you know, protein. And if you're vegetarian, you know how to eat, but basically you need to clean up your diet, and you need to make sure that you're getting enough sleep. And also, I think that it says don't ignore physical pain. You probably need to watch your consumption of social media. I know you're watching this video. I watch videos myself, but it's really good to give yourself a cutoff time. Like, there should be just a certain time in your day that you should probably have some quiet contemplation. Jungle Beauty Goddess Katara represents Earth, which represents caves, quietness, darkness, which means when it's time for you to go back to school, because we're talking about going back to school, child, it's time to get in your cage, child. It's time for you to just really ground yourself, to be very practical, get down to earth. It's time for you to get organized. It's time for you to develop a very rigid study schedule. It's time for you to be practical, okay? The next card I have for you is from Jungle Beauty Goddess Afar. And Jungle Beauty Goddess Afar's message to you is, and she represents our third eye. Ooh, she says, bring your dreams to life. So you know, I really feel like in this particular hand, and we're talking about you doing well this semester, you have a dream to do extremely well. So what you really need to do is, like I said before, organize your time, eat healthy, make sure you're getting enough sleep. And if you do these things, you're going to do extremely well. But she also represents the third eye in it, for us to examine some of our core beliefs about life, about ourselves. So if your family, if there are any beliefs in your family or anybody who's telling you that you're not smart enough, you're not good enough, or you're not good at math, or you're not good. No, she's saying you need to alleviate any negative beliefs you have about school. Because when you do that, you're going to be able to bring it to your consciousness. Say, you know what? All I need to do is apply myself, child. And if I apply myself, I can do math just as good as anybody else, right? I can do well. I can be a straight A student. So she's asking you to look at some of the core beliefs you have about yourself as a student. And when you tackle those beliefs, unravel those beliefs, bury those negative beliefs about yourself, you're going to bring your dreams to life. The next card I have for you is from Jungle Beauty Goddess Kalahari, who represents our heart chakra and our emotions, our ability to forgive and be forgiven, to be compassionate, to be kind. Her message to you is do what you love and become who you are meant to be. Oh my God, I love this She says, do what you love and become who you are meant to be. So you know what? I'm going to tell you what this card is saying. This semester, darling, when you're in school, I really want you to not, like, I'm just going to give you an example. You know, sometimes people say they want to be a teacher, but people are always telling them, oh, you can't be a teacher. You can't be a teacher because teachers don't make enough money. You need to follow your heart. You need to take classes that really feel true to your spirit. You need to think about, I really want you to take a moment and think about your purpose and what it is you really want to accomplish. And you know, another thing I want to tell you is sometimes I think young people think that if they choose, they're choosing forever. But you know what? Maybe you might want to be a teacher for, you know, let's say 10 years, and then you realize now you want to be a writer, and then you realize later that, oh no, I don't want to be a teacher anymore. I want to be a scientist, or now I want to own my own business. Don't be afraid to pick thinking that you have to be that for the rest of your life, because I have found that each thing you do builds on the next thing. You know what I'm saying? So when we say do what you love, what do you love right now? And I like to tell people, sometimes, you know, when you're really young and people ask you, what do you want to be? And you say, oh, I want to be a ballerina. People are like, oh my God, that's so lovely. And when you get older, if you say you want to do something and it's not practical, people start foo-fooing you. People start putting you down like, child, you can't be a fireman. You can't be an astronaut. You can't be a ballerina, right? One of the things I like for you to think about is when you were a kid, what did you really love, right? And think of, like, let's say, for example, some people might have wanted to be a basketball player. Now, but maybe now you realize you're probably not going to make the NBA. Right? So maybe you can make their uniforms, or maybe you can make design gym shoes, or maybe you can be a marketing person who you can work for the different, where they play games. You can coordinate those games. There is not a single career that you can think of that I can't tell you that there is an aspect of it that applies to every part of the human personality. So maybe you don't want to be a doctor, but maybe you can sell medical equipment. Or maybe you can, you know, create brochures that people really understand. Or maybe, you understand what I'm saying? So think about what you really love, and then think about how you can make it more practical today so that school means something to you. In order for you to do well in school, you have to see the connection between your work and what you plan to do when you're no longer in school. But the, one of the hardest things about doing what you love is that you have so many people in your ear, child. So many people telling you, oh, you're not going to make any money at this. Oh, there are no more jobs like that. And that really causes people to be confused. So I need you to ignore all of that noise. I want you to tap into yourself. Really tap into your heart energy. Get quiet. Think about when you were a kid and you thought anything was possible. Think about what you really want to do. The next card I have for you, and the last card I have for you in this reading, is from Jungle Beauty Goddess Sahara, who represents our mind, our intellect, darling, our throat chakra. And her message to you is, how you think will determine your happiness. Oh my goodness, this ties right back into what I was telling you earlier. If you think that, oh, I'm not really good at school, then you're going to have a tough semester. If you think, if you believe that maybe you had a teacher who put you down, right? And maybe it wasn't your best semester. We've all had them. You know what? Forget that teacher. Who cares what that person thinks? It's how you think. It's how you think about you that's going to determine how well you do this semester. So if I were you, start thinking really positive about school. And you know, one of the things I want to tell you, school is really not just about taking classes and getting A's. School is a resource of people. It's a resource of opportunities. It's an exchange of ideas. It's a place for you to meet lifelong friends. School is really, it's not just a socialization institution. It's a place where we meet to vouch for each other. I am a psychology professor. I've been teaching for almost 20 years. Before that, I was a social worker for 15 years. So let me just put this in perspective for you. I always always tell my students, you don't need me to do, you don't need me. You can take this textbook or this information, you can go to a coffee shop and read it with a cafe mocha. But the why you're in school is because you are vouching for each other. People are there to vouch for each other. Do you understand what I'm saying? So when you need a job reference, when somebody want to know if they should hire you, you know, that's why you're there. So I want you to be on your best behavior. I want you to understand your experience in school is going to be mostly based on the way you feel about yourself, the way you feel about letting go of any family or cultural patterns about, you know, school is for nerds, or you're not good enough, or you're not good in this information, believing bad teachers who told you that you wouldn't amount to it. You gotta let all that go. I mean, from this video forward, I want you thinking, I cannot wait to go to school, because this is an opportunity for me to exchange new ideas, to meet new people, to plant seeds, to figure out who I want to be and where I want to go in my life. I really hope this reading helps someone. Thank you so much for watching. And I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful semester.
You can't help who you love, but you can help
strong message for you to look. Maybe you're the type of person who you have some friends that maybe they're not in your best interest, okay? But you need to watch your social life this semester. Do you have a healthy relationship with your peers in your classroom, with your teachers? Don't let people run over you this semester. You may have to tell your friends things like, look, I'm sorry, but I can't listen to your problems about your boyfriend that you've told me 2,000 times because I have a paper to write, darling. In order for me to do well this semester, I really need to focus in on getting my work done in time, and I really, know I can't do your homework for you. I want you to start paying attention to your relationships and the people around you. The next card I have for you is from Jungle Beauty Goddess Kalahari again. So you're pulling in some strong emotional energy, which has to do with our identity, our self-worth, and our ability to love ourselves and feel good about ourselves. She says love without expectations. So I'm tapping into some emotional issues, some unconscious emotions that you have around some friendships this semester. When she says love without expectations, this is kind of like whatever you give, don't expect people like, oh, I'll let you, copy my notes, so now you have to let me copy your notes. Like, life doesn't work like that, but you want to be careful. Let me just tell you what this means. It just popped in my head. Don't stop being the wonderful, giving, loving person that you are, but only give it to people who deserve you. Does that make sense? So don't worry about when we say love without expectations. Sometimes we're really good to people and it's just a lopsided relationship. You're the one who's always letting them copy your notes. You're the one who is, helping them with their exam. You're the one who's carrying the weight of the friendship. But this hand is saying, look, find people like you so that you can give without expectations. You want to be this person, but you also want it to be reciprocated. The next card I have for you, and the final card for this spread, is from Jungle Beauty Goddess Sahara. And Jungle Beauty Goddess Sahara's message to you is, she says, she represents the intellect and the mind and our throat chakra, our ability to communicate. Use your intuition to acquire more information. So again, when you're talking about the heart chakra, the heart chakra has a lot to do with our emotions, right? And our unconscious feelings. So it means that we have to tune into, we have to let our feelings direct us. I know people usually say, no, those are just your feelings. But sometimes, child, your feelings are just, they tell you the truth. When you feel somebody is not loyal, or if there's someone doesn't love you, or if you feel like the teachers aren't, really don't care for you, like, trust your gut this semester. Trust your feelings. And then you have another card from your throat chakra with Jungle Beauty Goddess Sahara, who, she's talking about intuition. So again, this semester, in order for you to do well, I am going to tell, oh Jesus, I really think that you need to watch the people that you're hanging around. You need to tap into, you need to look for other resources, look for friends. This includes friends, this includes YouTube channels, this includes books, good websites, software that's going to help you do well this semester. And I think you need to really, how can I say this? Yeah, like your social life could impede you from doing extremely well. So one, surround yourself with people who are into school, who love themselves, who are emotionally healthy, who are kind, who are compassionate. This hand is telling me that any real concerns that could pop up for you this semester, it seems like they're going to be more about people that you hang around. So why do you hang around? Make sure you step outside of the box. And who you hang around can also include your teachers. Like sometimes teachers aren't always, you know, they may think, well, you were a bad student last semester, or I looked at your GPA, so I don't have faith in you. So I just want you to watch people, and I want you to trust your intuition. I want you to trust your emotions, and I want you to watch the relationships with people that you're around. I wanted you to make sure that again, you have cards that's telling you, use your intuition to acquire more information. Use your skills and resources to invent what is missing. So you have a strong hand that is telling you that you're going to have to rely on yourself a lot this semester to pull in additional resources so that you are able to do extremely well. Does that make sense? So the teachers are not going to always explain things well. You're not going to always get everything you need from the classroom, but you're being asked to look outside of the classroom and to find some wonderful resources, and you will have a wonderful year when you go back to school. I really hope this video helps someone. Thank you so much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Selected the purple butterfly, this reading is for you. First, I'm going to go over the cards, and then I'm going to give you my collective understanding about your hand. The first card I have for you is from Jungle Beauty Goddess Katara and Namib, and it says, plant seeds that bear the fruit of your soul. So this card is telling me right away that if you study hard, and if you manage your time, if you do extremely well, you're going to plant really good seeds that are going to blossom for you, and you're going to have an amazing semester. Jungle Beauty Goddess Katara represents our ability to be rooted, to be grounded, to be centered, to be practical, to be organized. And Jungle Beauty Goddess Namib represents our connection to our higher self. So this card is a very strong card that's saying that if you connect to your higher self, if you discipline yourself, you are going to have an amazing semester. The next card I have for you is from Jungle Beauty Goddess Katara. And Jungle Beauty Goddess Katara represents our root chakra. Her element is earth. And her message to you is, and she also represents, you know, being practical, getting down to earth. Your highest and best self is your only competition. Child, this card means this. You cannot compare yourself to other people, okay? Let's just say Becky got an A on her exam, and you got a C on your exam. You know what? Math may not have been your best subject, or whatever the topic is, or science, right? But if you gave it your best, then you should be proud of yourself. If you know that you didn't wait till the last minute to study, you did everything you could, you went to the resource center, you received additional help, you watched YouTube videos about how to do the problems, you were a part of a study group, and you got a C, you need to be proud of that C, because it was your best, because your highest and best self, babe, is your only competition. If you go back to school this semester with the mindset that I am only doing my absolute best and I'm not in competition with anybody, you're going to rock it out this semester. You understand that? You're going to do extremely well. Jungle Beauty Goddess Katara represents, her element is earth, which also represents cave. And the cave, which is also represents quietness. The cave means we isolate ourselves and we go within ourselves to tap into our strength and our power, our identity and our purpose. So basically, you might need to, you know, cut out some, you know, activities, some social media. You need to really develop a schedule, or a study schedule, I'm sorry, organized, get extremely organized. Have at least, I would say, 10 to 15 hours of study time set aside that is sacred to you, that you don't next card I have for you is from Jungle Beauty Goddess Afar, who represents our third eye and our imagination, our core beliefs about ourselves, our unconscious beliefs that really shape our life. And she says, use your imagination, darling. So when you're using your imagination, what she's asking you to do is, whatever issues that come up this semester, and if you can just, let's say you don't really understand what the teacher is talking about, or maybe everything is not clear to you, look for additional resources. Look for, you know, maybe there's software, maybe there are YouTube channels, maybe there's additional books you can read, but find a way to be creative about learning the material. Don't expect your teachers to give you everything you need to be successful. Does that make sense? Because a lot of times we think, oh, they're the teacher, they're talking so fast, so I don't understand what they're saying. She's saying don't tap into that. Use your imagination to, and it will help you do well this semester. So one of the things I'm going to tell you to do with using your imagination, instead of just writing down your notes, take a moment to draw your notes. Like after class, just for fun, draw stick figures. I don't care what you do. Draw your notes. And the best way that you can actually learn something is by explaining it to another person. So this hand is saying, for when you go back to school, in order for you to do well in college, you can't do the same old things that you've been doing in the past. You need to really, like, you know, maybe get some Play-Doh, you know, draw, you know, maybe make a song or a poem about whatever it is you need to learn. But once you tap into your imagination and have fun with the content, you're going to do extremely well this semester. I have one more card for you. And this is from Jungle Beauty Goddess Chobi. And Jungle Beauty Goddess Chobi, her message to you, she represents the third chakra, which is responsible for our self-mastery, our self-esteem, our self-worth, our power center, babe. She says, protect yourself. So what this means to me is that I feel that you need to, well, the message says, you know, clearly that you should protect yourself. But a lot of times protecting yourself, it's not like, you know, it means somebody is going to harm you. It just means to me, what I'm picking up from this card is protect your energy, okay? If somebody's asking you to babysit or go to the store or go hang out, you gotta tell them, no, John, I got homework. I got something to do. Protect your energy. Like, watch, if you watch a lot of social media, like, give yourself a time limit and say, okay, I have, you know, an hour a day that I'm going to watch my favorite videos, right? Or whatever I'm going to do. And when that hour is up, and then I am, you know, that's it for me. Or maybe you can say, after I study for 3 or 4 hours, then I'm going to go ahead and watch social media, but I'm only going to do it for 2 hours. In this hand, in terms of you going back to school and having a successful semester, it's telling you to protect your energy. Protect your time. Protect, you know, even pay attention to the music you're listening to, because sometimes the music can really, it changes our vibration. Pay attention to the type of shows you're watching. You know what I'm saying? So it's not just, it's not saying, oh, somebody's going to, you know, do this or that. No, protect your energy and make sure that you are utilizing your time in a way that is most beneficial to you, so that you will have an awesome semester. I really hope this reading helps someone. Thank you so much for watching. And I hope you have an awesome back to school semester. Thank you so much for